Let's sing to our King together this morning.
Let's sing to our King this morning. God, who can stop the Lord Almighty? You are such a great and powerful and mighty God. May we have a picture of that in our minds this morning, Father, as we worship you, Lord. May we picture ourselves at the throne, Lord. God, we wouldn't even be able to bear to look at you, Father, because your glory is so great. Your glory is so powerful, Lord. God, that you are such a powerful God who can move mountains. still working miracles today in our lives. You are a living God, alive and active. And may we understand today how powerful you are. When you stretch out your hand, Lord, who can hold back the Lord's hand? Hallelujah.
Night.
Father, that you reached down into the darkness of our lives, Lord, and you just pulled us right out, Lord. You are such a powerful God that nothing is impossible with you. And God, we know that if you are for us, that who can be against us? Greater is he who is in me than he who is in the world. We praise you this morning, Father, because we know the Lord of heaven and of heaven's armies has spoken, and who can change his plans? When his hand is raised, who can stop him? Who can stop the Lord Almighty? We're going to sing a song about that right now, the Lion and the Lamb. And we're going to talk about who can stop the Lord Almighty. And I want you to sing that out to him this morning. I want you to believe it with all your heart, because we serve a powerful God. We serve the Lion of Judah. And who can stop the Lord Almighty? Hallelujah.
Break. stop the Lord Almighty? Who can stop the Lord Almighty? Who can stop the Lord Almighty? Who can stop the Lord Almighty? Stop the Lord Almighty. Who can stop the Lord Almighty? Who can stop the Lord? Our God is a lion, the Lion of Judah. He's roaring.
Everyone on the earth, above the earth, under the earth, we will all bow the knee to the Almighty God, the Eternal Father. We will all bow the knee to our Jehovah Rapha, God, our healer. We will all bow the knee to the Lion of Judah who will come riding on the clouds, fighting our battles. Justice will be yours, Lord. You will have the final judgment. So I pray now that we would just start interceding for those who are lost, for those who don't know you, Lord. I pray, Lord, today that you would touch their hearts, that they would know there is a holy God, there is a perfect God who loves them. There is a perfect God who sees them. And Lord, I pray that any idol that they have would just break and fall to the ground, that those chains would be broken. The enemy has fed them lies. The enemy has brought them to himself with things of this world, things that will not last. But we know, God, you have made us eternal beings, and we will spend eternity somewhere. So, God, I pray for those lost today, that they will come to know that they will stand before a holy God one day. My heart breaks for them. Jesus, in your mercy, you have made a way for us to be with you. You have made a way of salvation through your Son, Jesus Christ. He was the Lamb of God who was slain, and he had victory over the grave, and that victory is ours. If we just accept that gift of salvation, may we intercede for the lost now. No one is beyond your reach, God. No one is too far from you. God, it just takes one prayer of repentance. One prayer of repentance, Lord. And everything can change. Everything can change. God, speak to their hearts now, Lord. Turn their minds to you, Lord. May they have a fresh encounter with you, God. Thank you that you pursue us, Lord. That you don't give up on us, God. You are such a great and powerful and mighty God. Yet you care for each one. It's your desire that not one would go astray. So God, may our hearts just be burdened for those lost this morning. For those who have strayed from you, God. May we have that heart of God this morning and just pray for them and pray for them to come back to you, Lord. Thank you, God. God, may we never stop believing in how great and powerful and mighty you are, that you are mighty to save, that you are the God that can move mountains. Lord, you can reach hearts that seem to be hearts of stone, and you can turn them into hearts of flesh. God, that you are a God that can redeem relationships. You can redeem time. You can redeem lives. Father, you can redeem any part of ourselves, Lord. You can redeem it, Lord, and you can use it for our good and for your glory. I pray we would be a church that is all about the glory of God. Lord, that we wouldn't be concerned with ourselves, but we would lay down our lives as living sacrifices. God, that we would just get on that altar every day and lay our lives down as a sacrifice to you, our loving and heavenly Father, saying, Lord, thy will be done. Thy will be done. Thy will be done. Father, may we bring glory to you in all that we do and who we are. Thank you, Lord, for your holy presence here, for your Holy Spirit that ministers to our hearts and helps us to say, greater is he who is in me than he who is in the world. We are conquerors through that Holy Spirit that lives inside of us. We are more than overcomers through Christ Jesus, and we serve a living God who has victory over the grave. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' holy name we pray. Amen.